Hey everybody, Tyre Metalhead Weatherman here. Hopefully everyone's doing well to start the week here. Just coming in and dropping a little update here in regards to the winter storm signal that we've kind of been seeing over the last few days for the south. So one thing that's kind of caught my interest here in particular is there's this winter storm severity index impact here. And this kind of highlights the probability of an impact level. So obviously looking 6 to 7 days out, you're not going to have a heightened probability of a major or extreme risk, but you do want to look for the little minor details, hence we're looking for the minor risk, no pun intended. But fact of the matter is, though, there is a little signal right here where we have a 20% area, and that's mildly impressive for an area that A, doesn't typically see wintry precipitation, and B, really the fact that we're, like I said, 6 to 7 days out. Can't have a lot of confidence in the model data here. And I think that's what's gotten a lot of people to talk with this system right now. But the thing that I'm making note of is a constant changing that we're seeing with the model data here. So one thing that I've made note of, and I'm gonna just jump this straight to about 150 hours out. And if we go to both the Euro and the GFS here, we're gonna put them both at about the same time frame here. So this is 150 hours out. These models came in not long ago, in fact. So this is pretty much the most up-to-date data that I can find currently. Here's a key feature that I've noticed. In the Euro in particular, that trough that we were looking at over the northeast and over towards Nova Scotia is actually moving more in this case now. It's not digging, it's just progressing. It hasn't really stalled or anything like that, so we're not getting that same kind of cold air there. So I think the Euro isn't on board with what we're seeing with this display here over here towards the south, or just really in general. I think this will be a rainmaker, maybe a cold rainmaker at best, based off what we're seeing with the Euro right now. But when we switch over to the GFS, though, it's a different ball game here. You also have a mid to upper level cyclone that's showing up on here, a lot more pronounced than what's been showing up on the Euro here. So we'll go back and look at this again, get back to that 150 hour mark here. And it's really taking a little bit longer for that system to organize here. However, if this strengthens enough, it could drag in a little bit of cold air too. And maybe, and I'm really kind of against it, maybe we could see something out of that. Right now, this is one of those things that kind of keeps me on the fence right here. But if you look at the GFS, it's a little bit more organized cyclone, a little bit more cold air in there. And I can tell that by the contour lines that we have here and the corresponding numbers. The lower the numbers, usually the lower the pressure, and usually the colder the temperatures. Whereas opposed to this, we were seeing 906s. At one point, we were even seeing 894 coming in. So that tells you that air is getting colder with this setup here as we continue to go forward. And that 900 holds up for a while here. Even as this storm's moving off, we're just now getting into the 906s here. But with that in mind, though, that might be another variable that comes into play. So it's not like we need all the cold air from that trough over towards Nova Scotia. We just need a little bit of it to get anything going. Like I said, I really think this is going to be something that's really tough for the models to pick up if it does do anything at all. It's really going to come down to more of a nowcast situation. Maybe convective models might pick it up. They might not. It's really going to be tough to pick up looking at just wind profiles alone. But from what I can see here, and like I said, we're going to just jump to that same time frame we were at before. Here's that cyclone right there. Also has a negatively tilted trough here, so I wouldn't be surprised to also see the return of severe weather over here towards the Gulf as we head towards this next weekend here. But like I said, the cold air with the Euro just isn't really there, which is kind of shocking because a lot of times whenever I look for cold weather setups or winter weather setups, Euro's pretty reliable with that. GFS can sometimes be a little bit hairy when it comes to those kinds of things as well. And we're just going to do the same thing. We're going to pretty much just look at the same time frame here, give or take a few hours. But notice the cold air is already in place here by 150 hours out here. So with that in mind, I'm keeping an extra close eye on this particular outlook, because if this drags in enough cold air, could see some wintry precipitation on the back side of it. I am still kind of favoring that Carolinas region towards the lower spine of the Appalachians here. It's pretty much going to be the target area if there's going to be any, because further up to the north, it's going to be kind of in a dry slot. Not much moisture is going to make it up there, even if we get the cold air. And then on top of that, the storm track is way too far to the south to really get much of anything as of right now. But with that in mind, though, like I said, the tale of two models here, and stuff like this is a real headache, having a model discrepancy such as this, because it just makes it really hard to have confidence and make a true forecast here. Because one model showing you one scenario, one is showing the other. And it's not that neither of them are right or wrong, it's just there's no agreement. And really, the best way to make a forecast is to have model agreement. So with that in mind, I'm going to show you what the precipitation looks like on here, and then we'll kind of highlight a little bit of the severe weather from this point. So here we are looking at that time frame once again. Here's that storm system. I do think that the chance for a few isolated severe wind gusts, maybe a couple water spouts, maybe even a tornado can't be ruled out. But for the most part here, like I said, that cold air is just kind of lagging here. Like I said, it'll be a chilly day, some cold rain, but nothing really showing up in the way of wintry precip on this one. A little bit different story when we go to the GFS here. So let's go to 150 right here, like where we were, if we can get this to stay in place. But if we go to 150 hours out here, look at how things kind of progress right along that area I was talking about, along the spine of the Appalachians here, mainly towards North Carolina. South Carolina does look like it gets close to being in the action here. It's literally gonna be on the either you're gonna get it or you're gonna be on the fringe of it. But mainly towards the southern tier of the Appalachians here is where we're likely to see some of that rain and snow. It also looks like there could be a case of some cold air damming that's going on over here towards the mountains that's keeping that colder air from pushing further to the south here. But really, I think what it's going to boil down to is A, temperature drop, and B, also surface temperature as to whether or not this sticks. I'm not really going to get into totals with this one because this is, like I said, this is one of those setups that could change at the drop of a dime. It's been doing that already, and I anticipate that to continue over the next few days until we get a little bit more of a definitive look from these models. And even then, we may not even get that, if I'm being honest. Not bashing the models, but these kinds of setups are really hard to pick up on. But let's get into the look for severe weather right now. And this definitely has the look of one of those high shear low cape setups. So basically, we're not going to be looking for any majorly impressive cape values or instability of that sort. But if we actually go ahead and take a look here, if we look between the second and the third, because I think that's when the chance is highest, you do see a couple of pockets of instability, and it looks like it, interestingly enough, will be more so towards the overnight hours. So that could also limit things. But I do think with that storm system being as strong as it is at the mid levels, it will help overcome some of that. I don't expect a high yielding severe weather event out of this as of right now, but there's definitely something to keep an eye out for if you're over towards the Texas and Louisiana coast in particular. Then down the line, maybe even Florida as well, as we go towards the end of this week into next week. Same pretty much can be said it with the GFS here. See the instability. We're looking more so towards the surface instead of the mixed layer this time. I'm just using what I have available really at this point. But like I said, there's a couple of points here where we have some moderate surface instability. Like I said, it's enough to get some storms going, maybe have them reach severe limits for a brief period. But like I said, I don't expect this to be a longer lasting event. If anything, like I said, Florida might be a little bit more interesting as we head from the fourth into the fifth. And then after that point, it's pretty much going to be a done deal from there. So that's all I got for you guys. Pretty much just a quick update on what we have going on. Don't forget, if you appreciate the content, if you've been enjoying it, don't forget to leave a like and a comment. Also, if you're new around here, definitely consider subscribing and also hit that share button. Definitely hoping we can get to 1,000 subs by the end of this year, if not more, obviously. But either way, appreciate you guys watching. Appreciate you guys being here. I'll see you again soon, where we'll probably have a February outlook coming up soon. Till then, enjoy the rest of your day. It's been Tyron Metalhead Weatherman. Take care and have a good one.